produce manager comes up to me and he says, Scotty, I seen that in the paper. Price Club's looking for a meat cutter and I heard they pay really, really well. And I said, oh, fuck, I don't give a fuck about that. Why would I fucking leave here? I'm making $15 an hour, you know. I had a great, you know, thing is, fuck, you know, why would I want to leave? He says, well, Scotty, you know, like, it's full time and you should really check it out because you'll never get full time or blah blahs. So I talked to the guys, you know, I talked to Jim and Ronnie and, you know, and I told them how I felt. I said, listen, I don't want to fucking, I don't want to leave you guys, you know? And, so I said, I don't want to leave you guys, man. And, they told me it was okay, and I had their blessing. Welcome, everybody! Let's do this shit. There we go, a little bit of fucking city in color. All right, let's get some fucking emails. All right, first email. Next question. Do you ever do more, when you do your drugs, do you ever do more than once every 2 weeks? And how much do you do? All right. Now I know why I've been putting off these fucking emails. Everyone's doing well. Beautiful fucking day here in fucking Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. Woo! 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 Yeah, a little hypomania there, huh? Well, what do you expect after that last fucking video I posted, eh? That number 42? Ah, tearjerker, eh? Madame Blue. Always gotta check the emergency brake on Kirk's car. First time I started driving it, driving around with the emergency brake on. Fuck. Was the day I got into my head that I wanted to be a stripper. Yeah, that's right, you heard it. A fucking stripper. I practiced in my basement for 3 months. Something a little mellower. Woo! Did I scare you? All right. First email. Did people treat you differently after they knew you were bipolar? Good question. Honestly, I really don't fucking know. I was very open about it, and I've been always a confident guy, so I never really gave a fucking shit what anyone thought of me. So, I think normally, I guess I should have noticed that. So all I can say is there is people that did treat me differently after that. Fuck you, right up your fucking ass. And to those that didn't, thank you. I'll come back and I'll show you guys a magic trick. See ya, two and two. It's time, magic time. See the dime? Now I'm gonna stick this right through my elbow. Ready? I won't cut away at all. Hang on. Get some lubrication on there. Okay, here it goes. Ready? Bang! Gone. Now I'll bring this hand down so you see there's nothing in it. That's magic, folks. All right, window down. I got my e-vape right here to go. You're real fucking smoke. Funny story. Okay, so I'm dating this this woman, right? Just gorgeous. She was actually a model for Levi's. Anyway, she's primo, eh? It's like a 10. 10! Personality, zero, zero. But anyhow, so I went to her place, and we were hungry, and I said, oh, fuck, we'll order a pizza, right? And this is back when I was part-time at Loblaws, right? More toppings, so. So I get on the phone with Pizza Pizza, I go, yeah, I'll take a pizza, large, whatever the fuck it was, with everything on it, right? So we're doing a thing, watching a movie, making out, fucking, I don't know what the hell we're doing. Knock the door, eh? Oh, must be the pizza, you know? And so I go to the door, and so he got the pizza, and he goes, that'll be $30-something. And I went, I just thought, I'm like, it's just fucking pizza, right? So it was all, everything I had, right? So I give him the money, and put the pizza down on the table. Tracy opens up, she goes, oh, I know why they charged you $30. I look over, it had every single ingredient they had on it. So when you order pizza, be careful not to say with everything on it, you know? Funny story. Well, this would have been a funny story. It didn't happen, but it would have been. This is back in my bodybuilding days, and you know, I'm working out and doing the protein thing, you know, 400 grams of protein, 8,000 calories, going like, going crazy, right? So, 90s, boom, 99.7 with a band who just released so my, my shits were, you know, pretty outstandingly large, you know, so anyways, and today was no different. So in the dogs, I had a couple dogs back then, right? And they're fucking yapping away, and fuck, you know, I do what I'm doing. I go out and see what the fuck commotion was about. Sure enough, fucking Shadow had shit all over the fucking floor. My own fault. I probably gave him too much treats or something. But anyways, the bathroom movement that I just had, we'll call it a movement, was still fresh in my mind. And so I was thinking, it'd be a funny joke to play on my girlfriend if, you know, I took that big shit out of the toilet and placed it down on the doggy pad. So when she came home, she would think the little tiny, like I had a little fucking, two little Malteses, they're like fucking 6-7 pounds, right? So she would think that this big fucking shit came out of this little fucking dog, you know? Just to say, fucking out of that 2,500, I took a 1,000 right off the bat, got fucked up, had a bunch of escorts over the house, you know what I mean? Just had some wild ass sex, you know, because I was fucking pissed. A little bit of tears for fears. 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 Okay, so I had no idea this was going on behind my back, alright? So anyways, I guess the part-timers were playing a rib on a joke on a new guy that came in. They were hazing him kind of thing. And I didn't know what this was going on. I'm not sure how long they were setting this up for. But here how it goes. So one of the part-timers comes up to me and says, Scott, I need a favor from you. I said, what's that? He says, we've been telling the new kid that you're going to approach him and ask him to suck your dick. And people, what are you fucking talking about? He says, we all told him that as part of our initiation, we had to suck your dick. So we all told him that we had to suck your dick, and it's just a matter of time before you ask him, you know, to suck your dick. So I said, and the guy's, come on, can you do it for us? Can you do it for us? I'm like, yeah, okay, fine, fuck, you know. I'll help you guys out, you know, because you gotta give it tape, because they paid their dues, now it's time for them to have fun with a new guy, right? It's the way it works, fuck. I'm in the back room, right? And I see the kid, he's, you know, in there getting supplies, and I'm like, oh, here's my chance. So I corner him, eh, and I stand right in front of him, and I just look at him like this. He goes, what? I said, you know what? It's time. The fucking kid just went white as I was pulling down my zipper, eh? And I can see him, like, getting lightheaded, eh? So I grab him, I give him a big hug, because don't worry, man, welcome to the club, you know, you're one of us now. I have an email question. Well, a question for you guys. So, remember I was telling you, one of my one of the things I had to deal with my bipolar was hypersexuality. You know, I had all the crazy coke sacks and all that shit, whatever. So, in order to kind of get back to regular sex, you know, I mean, kind of like, you know, cut out all the sex in my life altogether, so I had to learn this whole jerking off thing, which had nothing to do with the video, by the way. This is, I do my jerking off camera. But anyways, so, you know, my question to you guys out there who do jerk off on a daily basis, did you ever, like, lose it? Like, couldn't find it? Like, you know, you blow your load and you're like, where the fuck did it go? That ever happened to you guys? And I was like, I'm not going to get into the details, but just on this one occasion, you know, I'm like, fuck, am I in bed? Like, where the fuck did it go? You know, on the ceiling because I have a low roof. Like, there's no way it could have shut up that high. Yeah, but I couldn't find it. Like, is there times that nothing comes out or what? Please educate me. So I just thought I'd throw that out there, you know. This song sucks. With diamonds. Yeah, so I can't believe I just told you guys that story, but like I told you, man, I'm going to throw it all out there, you know. Nothing's taboo in Crom's Truck of Death. So, I think I'll just move on to my Dalai Lama for the day. We're talking about jerking off, this kind of leads into that. So, some of you guys out there, you know, not everyone can be a fucking champion like myself. You know, I can fuck, trust me, I can fuck. But it took a lot of practice. But, you know, it's only normal for some of you guys to premature ejaculate. You know what I mean? It's nothing to be embarrassed about, you know, a fucking, you know. If you're with any woman with worth a grain of salt, you know what I mean? She's not going to give you a hard time about it. You guys will work around it. But what I do is have some advice for you guys. So if you're on top, you know, and or any position that you're in, you know, and you feel that you know, you're right there and you can't stop it, take your fucking nipple yourself and just give it a good fucking twist. I guarantee you won't be coming after that. You know, or even communicate to the woman you're with and say, listen, you know, like, I don't have a lot of good holding staying power, you know, so, you know, if you're right, you want to get into it, you can even instruct her to pinch your nipple for you, you know, that way you don't have to think about it. So all you can do is, like, you know, going through your motions, you know, you're moving in there, and when you can feel like you can't stop it, just go to her now, and she'll fucking pinch your nipple for you and stop it, and that'll buy you guys, you know, 2 or 3 more hours. So anyway.